Greetings, Earthlings. Today I am answering a very frequent question, which would be, why is my microphone only coming out of the left-hand speaker, and how do I fix it? So in order to solve this problem, I'm going to start by explaining why you are having this issue. So if this is occurring for you, chances are that your audio interface is outputting a stereo signal to your computer, meaning there's a channel 1 and a channel 2. For this video, we will be using the Scarlett Solo First Gen, but it is the same for the Behringer UM2, the Scarlett 2i2 Second Gen, and if I'm not mistaken, pretty much every single two-channel audio interface. So when we're looking at the Scarlett Solo, if you connect anything to the XLR port, that means that you are using channel 1, which is going to be recorded to the left-hand side of a stereo track. On the other hand, if you're connecting anything to the quarter-inch high Z or line level input, that audio will be recorded to the right-hand side of the stereo track. So with that very basic explanation of how the inputs on a two-channel audio interface work, let's go ahead and jump into my recording software. I'll show you some examples, and I'll show you how to fix it. Additionally, gamers, have no fear, I did not forget about you. I also walk you through how to fix this in streaming software like OBS. Now, if you're recording into a DAW or a piece of recording software, you'll need to set up a mono channel rather than a stereo channel. So right here in Logic Pro, I am setting up a new track, and I will start by demonstrating the issue with setting it up as stereo. So I have input set to 1 and 2, I have input device set to Scarlett Solo USB, and output is really irrelevant at this point. So let's go ahead and click Create. Here is a quick test recording audio direct into Logic Pro on a stereo track using the focus. So you can hear the issue here where the audio is only coming out of the left-hand track. So I'll go ahead and create a new track and show you how you need to do it to get the audio out of both sides. Here we are setting up a new track, and instead of having input 1 and 2, we are only going to select input 1 because that is the only sound source that we are inputting into the Scarlett Solo. So I'll select that and then hit create again. Once we've done that, we can take a really quick glance at the mixer window to verify we've set it up properly. You can see that in this button we have it set to mono, which is correct, and you can also see that we have input 1 selected, and if you look at the meter, you can see that we have the correct input source selected. We can give it a scratch, and there you have it. It is set up properly. Of course, I'll go ahead and record something and play it back so you can hear how it sounds. This is a quick test so you can hear how the microphone sounds recorded to a mono track as opposed to a stereo track. So if you're recording into a piece of software, it really is that simple to resolve. Rather than setting up a stereo track, simply set up a mono track with the input source set to the XLR input that you're using for your microphone. So if you've already recorded something as a stereo track with your microphone on the left-hand side and nothing on the right-hand side, fear not, there is a very easy fix in Logic Pro 10, which I will show you right now, and I am assuming that there are similar features and similar fixes in other DAWs and recording softwares. So again, when we look at the mixing window, you can see that we are set as a stereo track by looking at this indicator right here. I will play it back for you. Here is an example of me recording as a stereo track. You can hear that it is incorrect. So we will click and hold on that stereo icon, and it gives us a bunch of different options for this track. We can select mono, stereo, left, right, or surround. For this fix, we will select left, and I will play it back now. I have channel 2 cranked all the way, but nothing is connected. And what selecting left has done is isolate the left-hand side of that stereo track and turn that into a new mono track. So it ignores the right-hand side of the recording completely, which has no information, and ultimately that will lead to a much cleaner signal. For demonstration purposes, I will go ahead and switch this to mono, let you hear it, and then switch it to left and show you the benefit of ignoring all that useless information on the right-hand side of the stereo recording. And I will use this to demonstrate the benefit of using the left isolation as opposed to downmixing the entire thing to a mono track. So you could hear that there was a lot of underlying hiss. That is because I intentionally degraded the audio by cranking the gain of channel 2 with nothing plugged into it. And when it gets downmixed to mono, it includes the microphone from the left-hand side, but also the noise from the right-hand side. So here I will actively switch between mono and left and mono and left. Here is an example of me recording as a stereo track. I have channel 2 cranked all the way, but nothing is connected, and I will use this to demonstrate the benefit of using the left isolation as opposed to down mixing the entire thing to a mono track. And that is how you would fix it if you screwed up and recorded your audio already as a stereo track. But now let's go ahead and look at how you would fix this issue if you are streaming. For this example, I'm using OBS 22.0.3 for the Mac. So the first thing we'll do is come down to our microphone slash aux, and then we'll jump into the properties. We will make sure that the correct audio interface is selected. In this case, we are using the Scarlett Solo USB. Click OK. Then we will go back into that gear icon and select Advanced Audio Properties. And all we should have to do to fix this is select the down mix to mono. I suppose we could also turn off track 2 because we are not using that. We will close it. And you can see in this meter right here, the audio is now mono, meaning the audio is coming out the same on both left and right. And the last thing that I want to note is that if you have a mixer that has a panning dial, make sure that panning dial is set to center, because if you turn it left, that means the audio will come out of the left. If you turn it right, that will make the audio come out of the right. If it's dead center, that means the audio will come out of both the left and the right. And there it is. That's how you resolve the issue of your microphone or your input only being recorded to one side of your track. Now, right here, I'm not going to ask you to like and subscribe, but if you do have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comments down below. And if you see a question that you want answered, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and I will select the questions with the most thumbs up and answer them over the next couple of months. So with that being said, I hope you found this very short video helpful. I will see you all next time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Thank you.